Touchdown! Heck yeah, Birds take the lead.
No, I'm screwed.
What do you mean you're screwed? Why you keep looking at your phone like that, man?
Look, man, I had a whole lot of money on the game, and now my bookie's finna come collect.
The bookie's getting to collect. You gotta stop with the gambling problem.
No, see, you actually don't want the gambling problem. I told him I was Kevin Hart.
You what?
Yeah, he won't take no bets from me no more because I owe him a whole lot of money.
You had to use my name?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, we gotta get ready. That's right. We're gonna get ready just in case I got to go Willie Tillman.
Wait, who is that, your crazy cousin from Compton?
No, it's not, but that's a good idea too. Willie Tillman was a Civil War hero who went all Die Hard on a bunch of Confederate pirates.
America had pirates?
Well, I mean, they called them privateers at the time. See, they captured Union ships and they sell them for money. At the start of the Civil War in 1861, the South didn't have much of the Navy, so they supplemented their forces with these privateers, a quasi-legal kind of pirate. Confederate privateers made a ton of money the old-fashioned way, by stealing it. They lurked along shipping routes in their own vessel, then boarded a passing northern merchant ship and overthrew the crew. Next, they sailed the captured ship to a southern harbor where a special court approved the seizure. The ship and its cargo were sold in auction, and the pirates, I mean privateers, kept most of the booty. One of the most successful of these pilfering vessels was 187-ton former slave ship called the Jefferson Davis. In her first 2 months at sea, the Jefferson Davis captured 9 different Union ships, and business was booming until they messed with the SS Waring. After capturing the ship, the privateers on board were steering the Waring back home to claim their prize, but instead they got a bloody surprise. Turns out this was one of the first recorded instances of pulling over the wrong black guy. William Tillman, a free man from Delaware, was the ship cook and steward. And he knew that the privateers made it back to the southern port. His future outlook was cloudy with the chance of chains. Willie wasn't going out like that, so he bided his time looking for an opening. The privateer captain was William Pastel. He kept Tillman on board so he could continue to serve as a cook. For 9 days, they sailed south into the Confederate territory.
Well, to the Confederacy and spoils of war. Should be in Charleston by morning.
And what shall become of our fine cook here, Master Tillman?
Oh, I'm sure such a fine cook will fetch a mighty fine price at the slave auction.
Good one, sir. That's a good one right there. Repeated use of the word fine. Fine cook. Fine price. You're a regular Mark Twain, a literary master. I get it. That show is hilarious, sir.
That boy sure does love wordplay.
Yes, although technically that was just repetition.
Whatever. All I know is he'll be a slave tomorrow, and that's just fine by me.
That night, Tillman went clubbing, if you know what I mean. Less than 10 minutes later, the ship was his.
Yeah, that's coming down.
Now I, William Tillman, a free man, I'm the captain of this ship.
5 days later, on July 21st, 1861, the Waring arrived in New York Harbor. As it happens, the first major battle of the Civil War at Bull Run happened on this same day, and the Union lost in a rout. So, news of Tillman's daring escape came at just the time the Northern public needed a hero to buoy their spirits. Tillman became a celebrity and performed at P.T. Barnum's American Museum in Manhattan.